If you use a mug versus a teacup, China teacup,
you want the other every day.
Because everybody's lying.
You have to use the porcelain is the best for the right experience. When you use a mug, the thickness of the mug is a barrier when you're drinking the tea. When you drink from the tiny teacup, especially the porcelain, it's very fine. So you want to find a cup that's very fine, because now the tea is going to go directly into your mouth. It's so fine. And you'll see the difference and you'll feel the difference. Just like wine, think about wine, it's the same thing. So a lot of times you have very fine leaves and then you have the bigger leaves. So what they do is they either use their hands to sort through the leaves or they use the machine. And so if you ever open up one of the Liptons, it's very, very fine. That kind of tells you the grading process. So the finer it is, it's just more powdery, and it's not really, good quality. So if you look from the leaves, you want to smell it and see that it's fresh by smelling it. But also just looking at it and see how it looks, because it's really important. Now, I know a lot of you think that if it's in a tea bag, it's better, but it really is not necessarily.
I have a question. This is somewhat of a debate in my household. I'm going to poll the room. I'm going to poll the room.
It's very strong, so half a teaspoon is all you need. So it really depends on the strength of the tea. If it's not that, like black tea is strong, you can probably use it a second time. Like the red tea is not, herbal teas are not really that strong. Like the sorrel is very strong though. But certain things like chamomile, lavender, those are not very strong. But it really depends. The second time you use it, every time you use it, it's gonna get weaker and weaker. And something that you don't really get to enjoy the whole flavor of the tea. So what does everybody else think of that? Does anybody
you
else
see that?
Because I'm one and done.
And the black tea is fully oxidized. Green tea is not at all. White tea is a little bit. And oolong is in between. Now, rooibos tea is not the tea, but has anybody ever heard of rooibos or honeybush?
Yes. Yes.
It comes from South Africa and it's naturally no honey. That's one of my favorite teas of all time because you can drink it all day long. And the best part, if you keep the leaves in, it never gets bitter. It'll get stronger, but never bitter. Just like the black tea or the green tea. So when have you ever brewed the tea and it's just very bitter, whether it's black or the green? A lot of times the water is too hot, or you've left it in too long. So it's really important for you when you're brewing tea to follow the instructions in terms of the time and the length and the temperature. So green tea is approximately 175. The white tea is about 180. Oolong is about 185. Black tea is about 195. And then the red tea is 200. And green tea, it takes anywhere from 5 to 7 minutes to brew, because it's not a strong tea, and it's not in the same category as the other teas. It's totally separate.